The effective capacity of two capacitors of capacity C1 and C2 connected in parallel is 25 by 6 times the effective capacity when they are connected in series. The ratio of C2 by C1 is, okay. So here, when the two capacitors are connected in series, the capacity, the effective capacity will be less. When they are connected in parallel, the effective capacity will be more. And also one more condition they gave. So what is that? C2 is greater than C1. C2 is greater than C1. Now, here, the effective capacity when they are connected in series is Cs is equal to C1 C2 by C1 plus C2. The effective capacity when they are connected in parallel is C1 plus C2. What is the relation they gave? Cp is 25 by 6 times of Cs. So there is C1 plus C2 is 25 by 6 times of C1 C2 by C1 plus C2. So cross multiply that. When you cross multiply, here you will get 6 times of C1 plus C2 whole square is equal to 25 times of C1 C2. So 6 times of C1 square plus C2 square plus 2C1 C2 is equal to 25 times of C1 C2. 6C1 square plus 6C2 square plus 12C1 C2 is equal to 25C1 C2. So bring this side. So 6C1 square plus 6C2 square. So if you bring this side, then so you'll get minus 13C1 C2 equal to 0. So divide the whole equation with, divide the whole equation with C1 square. Then I'll get 6C1 square by C1 square plus 6C2 square by C1 square minus 13C1 C2 by C1 square. So then is equal to 0, equal to 0. Then you will get 6 plus 6C2 square by C1 square minus 13C2 by C1 equal to 0. So let C2 by C1 is equal to x, which we require. 6 plus 6x square minus 13x is equal to 0. So if we solve this quadratic equation, we will get x is equal to 2 by 3 or 3 by 2. But 2 by 3 is denied because they gave C2 is greater than C1. So 3 by 2 is accepted. So that ratio C2 by C1 is equal to 3 by 2.